Okay. Hello everyone. Welcome to the lecture series on ARM microcontroller and embedded systems. This is lecture number 12. So in this lecture we will be discussing about the first part of the instructions. So there are many instructions. I have divided them into four parts. So this is the first part here. So here you will be introduced to the types of or the categories of instructions. In that we will explore one type. Okay, so here we have basically four categories. First one is moving a data, that is data transfer instructions. Next is data processing instructions. Next, execution flow control instructions. And last category is special instructions. So normally this one, moving data instructions, or it is also referred as data transfer instruction. So in this topic or in this lecture we will be concentrating on this particular category and their relative instructions. And in the coming lectures we will discuss about the other three categories separately. Now considering the first one here, that is moving a data in between a source and a destination. So as already we know, in the last lecture we have discussed about the basics of the assembly level language. So there we have seen the basic format of the instruction that contains opcode followed by operands, then followed by the comment field, and before the opcode we can include a label, where label and the comments are optional. And now if we refer or if we take any instruction, so that will be having the opcode is one part, but whereas operands can be a single operand instruction or two operand instruction or more than two operand instruction also. So basically here initially we will discuss about two operand instructions. And now particularly if you consider the move instruction, first instruction is the move instruction. So this move instruction is required to move a data between source and destination, or source to destination. So here in this regard we will see which of the things will come under the source and destination. So we will be able to transfer the data between the first category is register and register. So this one followed by memory and register, means data can be copied in between register to memory or memory to register, and also from special, in between special register and register. And not only that, we will be also able to, or we can move an immediate value into the register. So that is only the one directional movement. And in this move instruction we can use the register sets R0 to R12. So here a simple example, if you consider, that is move R8 comma R3, where move, where this move is the opcode, and R8, this is the destination. R8 is the destination register and R3 is the source register. So this is our destination, this is the source. So the content of R3 will be copied into the R8 register without changing the content of the R3 register. There is another category of move instruction, So that is referred as MVN, and it stands for move negate. So in the coming slides we will see the details of the instruction also. And basically the ARM processor, it is referred as load and store architecture. So that means the registers cannot access the memory locations directly. So in order to access the memory locations directly, the registers have to be loaded with the address of the memory. Then that is referred with respect to LDR instruction and STR instruction, which stands for load and store instructions. So regarding load and store instructions also we will elaborate in the coming slides. So right now we can use two instruction, one is LDR, one is STR, that is store instruction. Next question is, once we are able to move the data, so how much, what will be the limit on data size or data type? So that we have to discuss here. So the ARM processor, it allows, as it is a 32-bit architecture, so it allows up to 32-bit value to be moved or processed on a single instruction. So we know already byte is 8 bits, half word is, it is nothing but a 16-bit value. Here in ARM word is 32-bit. So this is 8, this is 8, and this is 16, and word is 32 bits. So this one we have already seen in the last lecture. And double word, it stands for 64-bit value. Okay, so if you check out these things, depending on the instructions we can use different data types. So say for example, if you want to move a data into more than two registers, so automatically you may think that you need to use two move instruction. So that is avoided in the ARM, where it will support multiple load and store instruction also. That means you can use a single instruction to read or write, or you can load or store multiple instructions without using move instructions multiple times. So those categories will also be elaborated. So those will stand like LDM, load multiple, and store multiple. And whenever we use these load multiple or store multiple, we can use the exclamation mark. So we can use this exclamation mark here, and this can be, so the use of exclamation mark is very specific here in the case of load and store instructions. This is particularly used for auto incrementing the base register value. This will be again considered in detail once we go to the load and store multiple instructions. Say for instance, now if you consider the given example here, STMIA.W. So R8, after R8 we have this exclamation mark. So that means if you assume that initial value of R8, if it is something like 8010, then after executing this instruction, so we have R0 to R3, totally 4 registers, where each register will take 4 bytes. Suppose if we had only R0, then this value will change to 10214 only. But now, since we have these many instructions, that is four registers. So if you consider four register, 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, 4 times, so that turns out to be 16 in decimal. In hexadecimal it is 10. So hence this value will be updated here in the R8 register. But if you don't use the exclamation mark here, R8 value will remain at 8000 only. Initially it was 8000, after using exclamation mark it has changed to 10. But if we do not use exclamation mark, the R8 value will remain to 8000. So this you will see in the demonstration video also. Okay, next, here if you look into the, or if you just note down these instructions, these are commonly used memory access instructions here. Okay, so now if you look into the first category here, so here we have few load instruction followed by few store instruction, and for all these load instructions, always in the case of operand, the operand, first operand will be destination followed by source. That is only in the case of load instruction. But whereas if you consider the store instructions, any store instructions, if you take, first operand will always be a source operand, then second operand or next to the first operand they will be the destination operand or operands. Okay, so how these things will operate here? So in the previous lecture we have discussed something about the suffix. So if you see here, after LDR everywhere we have few things except this third one. So neglect this one. If you consider first, second and fourth, after LDR we have B, here we have H, and here we have D. So this B stands for byte, H stands for half word, D stands for double word. So that means it is for 8 bit value, and it is for 16 bit, and this is for 64 bit. But if you use the LDR as it is, this is a default value, that is a 32 bit value we can take. Okay, so if you consider more specifically, this is for 8 bit and this is for 16 bit value, 16, and this is for 32 default value, and this is D, means it is for 64 bit loading operation. So here, as we saw in the details also, the load instruction, it is mainly meant for transferring the data or reading the data from memory to the register, and store is to transfer the data from register to memory. And similarly, if you consider for store also, the same thing will apply: 8 bit, 16, 32 bit and 64 bit. So now how these things will operate? So if I use here the first default instruction without any suffix, if I do not use any suffix, that is only LDR, then RD comma RN offset or without offset also. So this RD, it can be R0 to R12 any register, and RN also can be R0 to R12, but make sure that RD and RN, they should not be the same register namings. But here RD, in case of only the load instruction, RD will be the destination register. And if you consider the double word here, RD1 and RD2, two destinations are there. Two destinations and one source. Okay. Next, if you consider these are, so what will happen? Suppose if I use some instruction, something like, so something like if I use LDR R4 comma R5, that means we are moving the memory contents pointed by R5 register into the R4 register. Here R4 will be destination, R5 will be the source. Okay. And similarly, but if you use something like store instruction, so instead of load, if I use STR instruction, this is different now. Now what will happen is R4 will act like a source register, R5, this field act like a destination. Here what will happen? The value pointed by R4, that value and or the memory address pointed by R4 and its contents, that is the one case, or you can say register value R4, that will be copied into the memory address pointed by R5. So these things will be cleared in the demonstration video. So there, until that, you need to wait. Okay, so next, if you consider the similar fields, that is multiple memory access instructions. So LDMIA, STMIA, LDMIA again, LDMDB. So we can see here we have LD, that is load, ST means store, M stands for multiple, and IA means increment after, DB means decrement before. So we have many variants of these LDMIA and STMIA instruction that we will be taking separately again. Okay. Next. Next we have the concept called as pre-indexing and post-indexing. So if you consider the pre-indexing, so whenever you go for pre-indexing, so we use the exclamation mark after the bracket in the source side. So what is the use of this exclamation mark? So exclamation mark, if you use, or if you use the pre-indexing, the base value will be incremented automatically to the offset value. Suppose if you have something like, if some R4 is having some value 800 or 8000, so if I use something like here LDR dot W, then R2 comma R4 comma hash 3, then exclamation mark. So here the base register R4, the R4 value, if it is 8000, that will be changed to, now what will happen, the content of R4, that is 8003, will be copied into R2. So that is the use of pre-indexing. So in case of pre-indexing, if we use the exclamation mark, then only the base register value will be updated. But whereas if you take the post-indexing, so in post-indexing, it always, but here in post-indexing, we do not use any exclamation mark, but it always increments the base register value. So where these things are used, that is given here, and the format is also given. So this one also we will consider in detail. Okay. Next. Now if you consider the indexing concept here, so what actually happens in the case of indexing? So if you consider pre-indexing with write back means the value of the base register will be incremented automatically. So if you consider that, in other words, if you use the exclamation mark, with exclamation mark in pre-indexing, without exclamation mark in pre-indexing and post-indexing. So if I consider the auto-indexing here, since we have used the exclamation mark, so what will happen? R0 will be loaded with R1 value plus this value. So that memory content value will be copied into R0, and not only that, R1 will be changed to R1 plus R4. That is the main observation. And here, if you consider this one, pre-indexing without exclamation mark. So here you can see R1 is unchanged. Concept remains the same, but R1 value will not be updated, or any register whatever you use, that is not updated. And if you take the post-indexing, so in the post-indexing, by default, the values will be updated. So anyway, here no question of using the exclamation mark, that is not used here. Next, if you go through this comparison and example here with pre-indexing with write back and without write back, so what is happening in pre-indexing? So here basically two categories have been taken. One is pre-indexing with write back and without write back. So with write back means the base register value will be updated. So if you assume that R0 is this address, R1 is this address, so after executing this instruction, what should happen to R1? R1 is this value, it should be updated with plus 4, use of exclamation mark here. So after execution, R1 will change to this value. Its actual value was this. Okay. Suppose I think it should be 000904. Okay. So there is a slight typing mistake. So just update that everywhere. So this value, it has to be. One, two, three, four, 9004. So this is the actual value. So this you need to update it everywhere. So as you can see here, in this is here the exclamation mark is not used. So the base value is not changed. And similarly, this is the post indexing where the exclamation mark will be inherently assumed, and hence the base register value will be updated. So this is the one case. And if you consider the remaining things, next category we have the push and pop operation. So push and pop, they are related to the stack memory here. So usually the ARM controller, they does not support a separate stack here. So stack is included in the register set only. the R13 is the stack register. So it comes under the general purpose registers also, but a special register. So here the format for the or the main opcode for storing the contents onto the stack is push, and retrieving back the contents of the stack is pop. That is the opposite of this. So if you consider each things separately, so there is a format to be used here. That is, if you want to use the push instruction, so you have to use the push or pop, you have to use the flower brackets. So here, if you want to perform multiple push instruction, that you can define it in a single instruction. Instead of defining push R0, push R4, R5, R6, R7, R9 separately, you can include them in a single instruction. And similarly, while popping back also, you can take the similar concept also. And next, one more set here in the data transfer instruction is we will discuss the push and about the stack in detail in the the demo video also. Now next category is MRS and MSR. So MRS, so that stands for read processor status word, and MSR, that stands for write the value of the particular register into the control register. Next we have another categories, that is move yes. So move yes, this suffix yes, if we use, so that will update the what you have the PSR register value. So if I use move yes R0 comma hash 12, so R0 will be set to 12, no doubt. And also the this one, the program status register, will be updated. And in ARM we have some restrictions for certain range of the values, wherein you cannot load a 32 bit value directly, few 32 bit value, not all 32 bit value, directly into the register. So hence it supports two kind of instructions. That is, if you consider move W, this W stands for wide, that means it supports the 32 bit value also. So here if you take R0 is loaded with this value, suppose if you want to load R0 with 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, then you cannot load it directly. I cannot write move W dot W R0 comma hash 0x3456789A, so that will be an invalid instruction. So hence we need to use two instructions to load a 32 bit value, not all 32 bit value, few 32 bit values can be loaded directly. Okay, so that I will show you in the demonstration video. So if I use move W dot W R0 this value, so R0 lower half, that is bit number 0 to 15, will be loaded with 789A. And next move T, that is if you use, then upper half word of the R0 will be loaded with 3456. So totally a 32 bit value will be loaded now. And now if you consider the details of the instructions, okay, now we will consider the details of the each instructions. So some I will explain here which are very simple, and few instructions I will take it for a demonstration also. So totally here we will be discussing about almost all the instructions which you have seen in the previous slides. Okay, so let us start with the first simple instruction, that is the move and move negate. So I have given you the format here, opcode followed by operand 1 and operand 2. So operand 1 in few instructions it may not be destination and operand 2 may not be source for few instructions. I will inform which are the instructions. Okay, so now if you consider the move instruction, you need to use move followed by any register between R0 to R12. You can use particularly, and destination source can also be R0 to R12, but make sure that Rn and Rm should not have the same value. And let us assume that before we execute this instruction, R2 is having the value 02. I have taken only a 8-bit value here. Basically, the ARM processor, they operate on a 32-bit value directly. Even though if you use 02, so that is taken as 00, 00, 00 and 02, totally 32-bit value. So after execution of this instruction, what we can say is content of R4 are copied into the, they will be copied into the R2 register. So R2 will be replaced by 8, R4 will remain unchanged. And similarly, if you take MVN, that is for move negate, that means again destination can be any register, but source can be a register or an immediate value also. So let us take the register value as 8, or we can consider hash 08 also. So if R2 is 2, destination, and source is 8, then what will happen? So if you take the 1's complement of 08, 0's complement, 0 means here 4 bits you have to take, 00, 00, 8 means it is 1000 in terms of the binary. So if you take the complement of that, you will get what? F7. This is the negated value of 08, and always the source register or the source will remain unchanged. Okay, next, if you consider the load and store understanding concept here, so you need to consider here the, I have taken the LDR instruction, but I will also explain what is STR also. LDR, as we know, it contains again two operands, destination and source. So destination will be always a register and source is a memory address specified by the register. That is represented in a square bracket. So that may have a further indexing or may not have the indexing also. Okay, so next let us before going to the actual instruction, let us assume that these are the values before execution in the location. So if you take R0, so if you take R0, R0 address is this one, if you assume 15678, where 10 is stored, and R1 is this value where 20 is stored, R2 30 is stored in this location, R3 is having 40 in this location. So these are the values in the location, these are the address of the locations. And now if you execute say LDR R0, R1, where R0 is the destination register, R1 is the source register. So R1, now what should happen? R0, what is the address of the R0? It is 15678. Before execution, this was the value. And after execution, what would happen? The content of memory address pointed by R1, that is the content of 15679, that is 20, it has to be copied into 15678. So R0 value will be updated here. So R1 and R2 will remain unchanged, And now if you consider the store instruction is little bit reverse here. So this first operand, this will be the source. And this will be the destination operand. So what should happen now? The content of R2 should be copied into the means content of R, not content of R2, as content of R2 should be copied into R3. So if you consider the memory location content, so R2, if it is 30 or if it is having this value, so this value has to be replaced. This value has to be replaced in the memory location. Where it has to be replaced? It should be replaced in the memory location pointed by R3. Memory location is this. So if you consider the next memory location, so I have shown here R3 has to be updated with the R2 content, that is 30, that is updated here. So sometimes if the value itself is 1567A, so here you can have 1567A also. Okay. So this is how these things will operate. So next, these are the few variants here of the load and store instruction. So if you consider single register load and store, load S and store S, so these are the few variants here. So we will elaborate these things one by one. So we have talked about already the indexing, how it will operate. So next, if you use the post indexing, these are the few instructions. So next we have another set of post indexing, where you can see the changes as I have already explained in the earlier slides. Now if you consider the multiple register load and store, so as I told, I will be explaining later. So these are the slides here you have to consider. So we know already LDMIA, so this stands for, LDM means load multiple, IA stands for increment after. So how it is operated? This is the destination and these are the source registers. So if you use increment after, then values will be considered from R3 to R6. So if you consider this, so first what will happen, the the memory location of R1, it will be updated with R3, then it is incremented. So what will be incremented? R1. R1 will be incremented by 4 bytes. Next, R6 will be incremented. So sorry, R1 will be incremented with respect to the R6. So if R3 is having some value that is stored in the present value of the R1 where it is pointing, next after loading that content of the R3, the R1 value will be incremented by 4. Then after loading R5 there, it is again incremented by another 4, 4 plus 4, that will be 8. But if you use increment before, if I use, so increment before means what it will do, it will increment before means it will take it like R1 plus 4. So if R1 is having something like a value like 200, so initially the value will be incremented before loading the content of R3 into the R1 location. So if R1 is 200, so 204. At 204, R3 contents will be copied. Again, it will be incremented. At 208, the R5 content and 20C, at that value, the R6 content will be copied. So we will see one by one. So here we have many variants, and along with that the suffix A means I means increment, D means decrement. This can be I or D, and this can be A or B. A means after, B means before. Okay, so now if you consider the similar approach for store instruction, store multiple. So here I have shown you all the four categories. First one here is store multiple increment after. Second one is increment before. Third one is decrement after. Then another one is we have decrement before. So before you note down these things, so I just want you to note down this particular value. Please note down this value, that is 100C. So this is the reference value everywhere you have to consider. So if you assume R9 is having 100C as a value, so how it is incremented and decremented and how the instructions are executed, so that you have to consider. So as I told, first one, if you consider, STMIA, store multiple increment after. So there is a exclamation mark, that means R9 will be updated. So present value of R9 is this. So for every iteration, R9 will be updated. So now, as we know, increment after means it has to store, then it has to increment. So here the source is R9 and destinations are R0, R1 and R5. So initially the initial value of R9, so that will be stored. Where it will be stored? Source is this and destinations are these things. So content of R9 should be stored in memory location pointed by R0. So it may be any memory location, but we are interested in the how the value of the R9 is updated. So here if you consider, after first iteration, after moving the content of R9 into R0, means the memory location pointed by R0, so R9 will remain as it is, then it is incremented. This is for first iteration. So if you go for second iteration, so here the R1, before it actually loads the R9 content into R1, it will be incremented. So it will become what? 100C plus 4. So plus 4 means it is now C, D, E, F and plus 1 means 10. So this will be 1010. Next, the content of R9 will be copied into R5, and once it is copied, it is incremented. So it will be copied here at location 10 plus 4 here again. Then it is incremented. So this is store and increment after. Store, increment after. Store, increment after. So now if you check the value of R9 in the execution, so you will see that R9 has changed from 100C to 1018. And similarly, if you take increment before, that means the base register value will be incremented before only, before copying the data or before storing the data. So that means R9 is again 100C. So this present value of R9 has to be stored in R0, means the memory location pointed by R0. How it is done? First, base address is incremented. That will become again the same thing, 1010. Here R0 will be stored. Next, increment before. After storing this first value, it will become 1014 and like that. So if you consider this increment before, here store now, increment before, store now, increment before, store now. So like that it will be taking place. And similarly, if you consider decrement after, so if you consider the decrement after instructions, so operation is also a little bit different, and the way of decrementing the address is also different. So how these things will operate? These things will be operated on the operands in this direction. So here in both of the cases it will be like this, but here it will be like this. It will take from the last register location, memory location pointed by the last least of the register. So here what should happen? It should store anyway, but it should decrement the register, means present base value. Present base value, we know this is the base value. So how it is done? Content of R9 will be copied into memory location pointed by R5, it may be some memory location. So after loading here, the value will be decremented. Store and decrement, or decrement after storing. So again the same thing. So now it is 100C. So this value will be 100C minus 4. So what will be the value? C next, that will be BA 9 and 8. So this will be 8 here, and this will be 04. So the base address will be changed from 100C to 1000. And now similarly, if you consider decrement before, as we had increment before, the address will be decremented. It will be 8 here, and same thing, 8, 4, and this value. This is how it will operate. So this is the program which I have used for demonstration. So how it will operate, I will show you in the demonstration video. So this lecture will be followed by demonstration video, or at the end all the demonstrations videos will be uploaded. Okay, so for your reference you can just note down these instructions and you can work on that. So please note that here I have not used any of the STMI or any of the instructions. So to make it simple, I have taken it in a another program. Okay, and always remember that while typing in the Keel software, so where I have shown all these things, variables and all, I will explain there. So here you need to type it from the first line itself, first column itself, without any space. And this one also, you should not give any space. Rest all, for rest all instruction you have to give the space. Okay, so this I have already explained in the lab, you can refer that, and we have already done with the few demo videos also. Next, as we considered the store instruction, similarly if you consider the load instruction LDMIA, so it is same again R9 comma R0 R3. It is same as executing four. What we are doing, we are storing again destination comma source. So this and this one, instead of writing four instructions separately, it is replaced by a single instruction. Okay. And this picture will give you the clear idea about how increment after, increment before, decrement after and decrement before will operate. So it is common for both the STMIA and LDMIA, this concept. Okay. Next we have the stack memory. So usually R13 will act like a stack register here. So depending on the architecture, we may have an ascending stack or a descending stack. So ascending stack means the base value of the stack register SP will be incrementing after each push instruction. Descending means it will go down, it will grow in a downward direction. So we will identify whether it is a ascending stack or descending stack in the program. Okay. So here is the program which includes both STMIA and maybe LDMIA and along with push and pop operations also. So I will consider these examples separately in the demo video. Okay, so we'll just stop here. So in this lecture we have just discussed about the basics of the data transfer instructions with their details also. Thank you.